my way to the Basquiat exhibition, and I arrived a bit early. So to kill some time, I decided to stroll through the High Line, which is an elevated park on an old railroad line. There's seating, lots of flowers, art, and vendors. I love the views and how unique this space is.
To the gallery now, and I've never been over here. Like, I've never been this far west in Chelsea. Pretty cool, much quieter than the High Line, thank God. So excited to see the Basquiat exhibition. So freaking excited. And I'm meeting up with my friend Paris. We go to see art together, and I haven't seen her since like 2019, so I'm excited to catch up with her too.
This is my friend Paris.
What is it, TikTok?
I'm vlogging.
Action.
Okay, so we just finished the exhibit. Or you want me to just riff? Someone's coming, so I just wait for you guys. I thought it was very well done. There was so much art.
Although I live in New York City, I've never seen Basquiat's work in person. As soon as I heard about the exhibition, I purchased tickets right away. King Pleasure runs through January 2023, and as you can see, you can get pretty close to the art, which I love.
I think I learned about Basquiat first from Tumblr, actually, and it was just really cool to get, to see his art through kind of, the perspective of his family members. His sisters organized the exhibit, and I really loved it so much. I especially loved the videos and their little interviews, just talking about growing up.
He knew very early that he wanted to be an artist.
He wanted to be famous because there were not a lot of black men like him who were recognized in the same way.
He'd be speaking the truth, you know, about racial injustice, about social injustice, about people and humans and how we all relate to each other.
And the really cool part was them recreating the studio.
Basquiat lived and worked in his downtown studio, which was actually in a building owned by his friend Andy Warhol. The exhibition's soundtrack is music that Basquiat loved and drew inspiration from, like Charlie Bird Parker. There is so much art to take in. I would honestly love to come again and spend more time viewing, reading, letting the art speak to me. The last stop on this tour is the Palladium, which was a legendary venue turned nightclub that Basquiat and the rest of New York loved to party at in the 80s and 90s. In addition to other artists like Keith Haring, the Palladium commissioned Basquiat to create a mural which lived behind one of the bars.
All right, so we made it to the end of the exhibit.